right now around the world, people use about 15 to 18 terawatts of energy. This is a watt is a measure of how much energy is being used at a given time. And so 15 to 18 terawatts is how much all aspects of human civilization use, which seems like quite a bit until you realize there are 87 to 89,000 terawatts of solar energy shining on the Earth. And there are 370 to 3,600 terawatts of wind, depending on how much wind there is, that are blowing around the Earth. So there is a huge amount of renewable energy that could potentially serve this global consumption. However, an important problem with renewable energy sources is that they're often intermittent. And this is sometimes called the intermittency problem. So here we see a graph of the wind speed over time. And you can see that it changes. It goes up, and then it goes down, and it goes up, and it goes down. And this is very common. Another example would be the sun, that the sun rises in the morning, and it sets at night, and you don't get solar energy at night. And this is one of the big differences between renewable energy sources and fossil fuels. With fossil fuels, you have a big tank of oil, and you can burn it whenever you want it and have a continuous flow of energy. With renewables, that's not necessarily the case. And this is one of the real challenges with renewable energy sources, because we currently do not have very efficient battery storage. And therefore, when you have extra sunlight, it's not very efficient to currently store it and then use it at another time. One thing, though, that is happening to try to facilitate the use of renewable energy sources, though, is called the smart grid. And this is a project that is being undertaken by researchers and that is making its way into the real world that seeks to allow for energy to be consumed in a much more dynamic way than it currently is. Just as the internet is a much more dynamic process, a set of processes than old-fashioned, flipping light switches was some of sort of where it comes from. The notion of the smart grid, rather than just plugging your computer into the wall, the smart grid will track all of the energy that is being used and who's using it and addressing it in a similar way to data is addressed when it moves around the internet. This can then allow for things like the dynamic pricing of energy. So for example, you could put your clothes in the washing machine and set it to wash it within the next 8 hours whenever energy is cheapest. So for example, you put it in before you go to bed and you press go, and it waits until 3 a.m. when energy is at its cheapest, or 10 p.m. or 6 a.m. whenever energy is cheapest, and it then washes your clothes. They also talk about using hybrid car batteries to buffer uneven load. So if everybody had a hybrid car in their garage, those batteries could then be used to iron out some of the intermittencies of renewable energy sources. So there are a variety of benefits and drawbacks to the smart grid. Some of the benefits are it allows for more efficient energy use, and it allows for the integration of renewables, which would be really valuable. And it reduces the vulnerability of the energy grid to various different kinds of perturbations. But there are some drawbacks as well. It allows for greater surveillance. So if people are able to, if various organizations are able to track people's energy usage, it's yet another way that big organizations can know more about the everyday activities of the populace. It also could lead to disenfranchised communities. Right now, there are a lot of power outlets in the world, and a homeless person can often find a place to plug in technology if they wanted to. But once every aspect of the energy system is tracked, it no longer becomes possible to just plug yourself into the wall, because if you aren't registered with the system, it won't give you any power. And it's also possible that cybercrime could be more prevalent, that people could steal energy in various different ways. And so those are some of the drawbacks that come along with it. So now what I want to do is to do some simple calculations to think through how much energy people use. So the average person consumes about 2,000 calories of food a day. And a calorie, when you see it on the back of like a cereal box, is actually a kilocalorie when scientists are talking about it. So it's 1,000 calories. So we actually consume about 2 million calories a day of sort of science calories. 1 watt hour is about 860 calories. So if you divide 2 million by 860, you get about 2,325 watt hours, which if you divide that by 24 hours, you get 97 watts. What this suggests is that the amount of energy that I use or you use or any person uses is about the same as a 100 watt light bulb. Turning on a 100 watt light bulb is about the same amount of energy that I need to live in the world. Now that's an interesting prospect, because once you know that I'm about a 100 watt light bulb, you can then start to think about how do I relate to a certain amount of solar energy. And you can realize, you can look at a calculation and find that in a square meter, so something like that, there are 163 watts of solar radiation over the course of the day. So at 100% efficiency, a square solar panel 2.5 feet on a side could power a human. Now, there's no such thing as 100% efficiency, but nevertheless, it suggests that the sunlight shining on a certain area could potentially be on the scale of the power needed to provide a human with the energy that we require. So this, in discussing it with students and colleagues, has brought up ideas of like a solar umbrella, where an umbrella is about the size that you would need to collect all of the energy you needed to power yourself, or something like a solar-funded lunch, where if you want some lunch and you don't have enough money in your account, you go outside and spread out your solar panels and wait half an hour, and some money is then dynamically put into your account through the smart grid, and you can then go buy a sandwich. And the reason I think this is interesting is that it can change how we think about energy. Right now, energy, we're pretty disconnected from energy. We buy gasoline and we can drive around, or we plug into the wall, but we don't think that much about energy. The smart grid and renewable energy sources can potentially give us a much richer relationship with the energy around us. And that has the potential to open up really interesting new avenues for our future civilizations. Thank you.